Welcome to Selling Power TV. Today, it is my great pleasure to welcome six sales rock stars: Alice Hyman, Sherry Levitin, Mark Hunter, Walter Waldman, Andy Miller, and Anthony Iannarino. We are going to talk about six great strategies for selling in tough times. And we have our first presentation by Walter Waldman. He's a lieutenant colonel. He is a former fighter pilot. Ready, Waldo. Take it over.
Everyone heard that I was a fighter pilot in the military. And obviously, in that environment, you have to operate with extreme focus and extreme discipline. Watching Colonel Robin Olds, a retired one-star general, actually speak at a graduation. So he shared a story that I want to share with you, and I'm going to abbreviate it. Colonel Olds was leading a four-ship of F-4 Phantoms in Vietnam to take out a target. I believe it was a bridge. Very strategic target. And the young wingman, number four, called out on the radio. Number four is visual or tally, four enemy aircraft 20 miles low. He communicated that enemy to Colonel Olds, and Colonel Olds acknowledged. And he said, negative, press, meaning they were pressing to the target, which was briefed that day, the strategic target. They destroyed the enemy bridge, came back a few hours later and debriefed, because every fighter squadron, every fighter pilot debriefs a mission. And when it came to the number four wingman, when it came for him to speak, he said, sir, why didn't we take out those enemies? And Colonel Olds said something I will never forget. What you didn't see was the enemy four ship at our right 5 o'clock behind us in the sun, where we couldn't see them, waiting for us to roll in on that decoy so that they can come in behind us and shoot us down at our 6 o'clock. It really underscores the importance in a high-performing environment to stay focused and disciplined on the tactic at hand, the thing that will move the lever, the sale that you brief that day that you need to take out that will make a difference for you and your team that day, that week, that quarter, etc. Beware of distractions disguised as opportunities. We have distractions every single day, low-hanging fruit, a prospect that calls, a friend calling for our nurturing, our advice. When you need to stay disciplined on target in your day, now more than ever, when you've got your kids running around upstairs, homeschooling, a new reality, learning how to use Zoom, take out the critical targets and perhaps delegate the smaller ones to your team, or engage them another day.
Well, thank you, Waldo. That was excellent. We're going to move on to Sherry Levitin, and she is going to talk about the five steps to winning in tough times.
The most important thing I can share with you right now, and particularly during tough times, during a pandemic, is to lead with empathy. Trust is made of five components, but it's empathy that gets you in the door. It's competency, reliability, integrity, and vulnerability that keep you there. And I'm going to give you three quick things to think about, and the rest will be in the handout. Number one, ladies and gentlemen, like Jared, do your homework. Don't make it generic. When you do your homework, before you prospect, before you talk to a customer, go on LinkedIn, go online, find out everything about them, make it specific, make it personal, or as I like to say, show me you know me. Number two, when you get with the customer, when you get them on the phone, ask questions that reveal their problems. I call it solve to involve. Three types of questions you need to ask. Skin questions are fact questions, but you want to dig deeper and get to bone questions. Bone questions reveal problems. Our customers have a ton of problems right now. You need to listen to them. It's even more important to listen than it is to solve. And finally, you want to ask heart questions. Questions that get to the heart of what really matters. And today, our customers are dealing with all types of emotional issues. And finally, what you want to do in a time of a pandemic to lead with empathy is don't just think about the products and services you're selling. Think about the experience that you want to create. As Waldo said earlier, people are at home, they've got their kids, they're in a new environment. So before you contact your customer virtually, instead of just looking at all the things you want to say, write down on a piece of paper, how do I want my customer to feel?
Let's move on to Mark Hunter, the sales hunter. He's a great friend, a great author. Your latest book is A Mind for Sales. Now, let's talk about A Mind for Removing Obstacles.
I'm going to share just a quick story about a situation that happened a little over a year ago. But boy, does it apply today. Company I was working with, salesperson, had a major sale that he was looking to close. However, it was getting very much caught up in the process of the customer. This sale was going to take way too long to close. Gee, does that sound familiar with what's happening today to things? How did he get the deal to close? What this salesperson did, he said, I can't win the big deal, but I'm going to survive. He broke the deal down into many smaller units. Did it take more time of his own time? Yes. But it actually allowed the sale to move through much faster. And he was able to close the deal in smaller segments. And over the course of the last year, actually wind up creating more business, more revenue for his company. But better yet, was able to penetrate this company at a much deeper level. You see, what you have to stop and think about when it comes to sales is not about selling anything. Sales is about helping our customers achieve something. And the more we understand that, the more we can relate to that. It is amazing because right now we're in work from home. Yes, but you know what? Our customers are BFH, buying from home. And what does that mean? That means their buying system is set up differently. Their processes are different. This is a time where we say, what are the obstacles I remove to make it as easy and as simple for our customers to win? They'll win. And when they do win, we win at the same time.
We are going to move on to Anthony Iannarino. And Anthony is the author of three wonderful books. Welcome, Anthony.
Thank you, G. Good to see you. So as soon as this pandemic started, I started to get emails and tweets and LinkedIn messages saying, what are we supposed to do now? Should we stop selling? Well, if you can help people in good times, you damn well better go out and help them in bad times, because now they really need our help. And so the first question is an easy answer. You must keep selling. And I had a number of email conversations with people so that I could get a feel for the objections. And they sounded something like this: how dare you call me at this time? And there's a lot of energy in there. And there's a lot of somebody who, I mean, normally when you're prospecting and calling people, you can run into grouchy people. That's just part of the game. But they're specifically grouchy for a different reason. And what that leads us to is that you're going to get a different kind of objection right now. So because they have an actual fear, and for many of them, there is an existential threat to their business. So the first rule in overcoming objections in a time like this is you have to be empathetic. You have to have empathy. Empathy means walking a mile in someone else's shoes. But I like compassion better. Compassion means recognizing that their shoes are three sizes too small for them, and then going out and getting them a pair of shoes that actually fits them. So the second thing is you have to be patient. It's going to take them a little while to process this, and you're going to have to take a little bit of time to get through that. The other thing that you're going to have to do is start making your conversation future-oriented. You just have to project into the future and say, listen, Gerhard, I'm not asking you to make any decisions right now, but I would like to share some ideas with you, because in the future, we will have a chance to do something, and I have some resources and some ideas about how we can get your business back faster. And then your value proposition has to change. So what are they concerned about? Survival first, and then recovering what they lost after that. So all of your conversation has to lead to these kinds of concepts, and you have to lead with the empathy that says, I understand where they are. I'm going to be patient. I'm going to try to help them see this future that they may not be able to see right now. And then I'm going to work with them to find some way to get them a better outcome than they have without my help.
Now we're going to move on to Alice Hyman. She is the MC of Sales 3.0 Conference. And today she is going to talk about sales leadership lessons from the edge.
So the edge, I think that's where we all are right now. We're on the edge of our seats. We're on the edge of what we can do. We're on the edge of trying to figure out what's new, different, powerful, and how we can help. I think a lot of us really believe that sales is leadership. And all of us in sales are leaders. And what do? Leaders help. Your prospects are depending on you to find them. They need you right now. So as leaders, it's our job to help people make good decisions. And sometimes when we're confused and afraid and worried, we don't make good decisions. And so our customers are out there making decisions in a vacuum without our help. And that's a dangerous thing. So in leading, we have to lead to the future, lead to brighter days. Yes, some things are really bad right now. Some industries have been heavily, heavily impacted. Those things are all true. And on the other side of that, there are some industries that are doing amazing things. Their sales are through the roof. And then there's the rest of the people that are somewhere in between. So as we think about how we can lead from the edge, we need to think about how we can help our customers and prospects make great decisions, decisions that will impact their future in a really positive way.
And now we're going to change speakers, and we talk with Andy Miller about the art of pivoting in a crisis. Andy?
So I want to talk about the art of pivoting, because my belief is no matter what's going on, no matter how bad things get, there's always something that you can do to get a better outcome. And it may take some pivoting to find that. So a couple of weeks ago, I got a call from a client of mine who has a sign business, and he focuses only on signage for parking garages. Well, we got a problem. Everybody's got a stay-at-home order, so nobody's driving, so they're not parking their cars, so the garages aren't making any money. And he said, I think I'm going to have to shut my business down. I said, well, hold on a second. Let's explore what your possibilities are, because there's always something that you can do to make a more favorable situation. How about commercial real estate agents? They're out there. You know, changes are going to happen with office space. They're going to need to advertise that. And what he ended up doing, I said, call your parking garage folks, see if they need some signage, but also ask them for an introduction to their commercial real estate agent. He did that. He ended up bumping into somebody who was part of a network of 300 commercial agents who were looking for a company that could do signage for them. So all of a sudden, he's got 300% potential clients. This is something you all should write down. It is, in frustration comes opportunity. What came out of that was a number of them needed signage for the buildings that they worked with for social distancing. And he is so excited because he said, Andy, I'm getting orders of the size I've never seen before, and I'm getting them easier than before. And it's just talking to people, finding out what they need, and then helping them get what they want. The key here is you've got to talk to people. You've got to find out what their frustrations are. What do they need? Don't worry about making a sale. Worry about giving back. There are lots of possibilities for you to pivot in your business. How do I pivot? How do I help people? How do I do this? How do I do that? Because the how do I is what starts to create the innovation and the creativity.
Thanks, everybody. We're going to do this again soon. Thank you so much.